is consisting of Grand Champion of Rocket League, which is Bertie. Dancy's Logsy. Target Bone is Dream. And CSGO player is Thomas. And already early action as Bertie pushing through with his teammate there towards Squeaky. And already three plays, four plays towards A. Just a single player towards his B bomb site. And now the T's understanding that they might be able to take mid, but already another fast rotate for the CT side.
A fast rotate, but one that's still looking to be a bit more difficult for them as they get themselves a 1-for-1 trade. Logsy more happy for a headshot, but Devaser wants to contest. But look at that bomb positioning. That's awkward.
Yeah, unfortunately for them, that might be quite hard to retrieve. But Yoshi, they're taking down Dream. Makes such a big difference into this round because that forces a player Highway to leave Highway, not watch the bomb, and instead have to watch a main. So pressure relief from the T side here as Logsy's finding information. It's a nice headshot there onto Debaser. If only he had this aim with a rifle. Anyway, Thomas has a nice fading one tap. Finds the kill onto Yoshi. Again, another one tap there from Thomas and expects the player to be towards mid. As he jumps on Highway box. He's sitting there like, oh my God, guys, check the stream, watch the stream. That's pretty what he's saying right
that
now.
That is happy days right now for him. Smooth shots.
Yep, I asked the players to change their name. Bertie for Snods, Dancy's Logsy, Thomas, and Target Bonus Dream. I don't think Dream will change his name. But yeah, and obviously underscore, you see the player there, the line as a name, that is Ash. And then Quiver, Mezzi, Ash, Yoshi, and Debaser.
Wonderful. You know what?
Definitely
you know what
been a weird night, a long night.
Yeah,
tell
I'll tell you what, I was expecting to come on tonight and just do some quality casting, but this really has been quite the entertainment and quite the fray. But nonetheless, what is also a bit of a fray in itself is Logsy over towards this site as he finds himself a double kill. Quick third to be claimed as well as Ash get a fall, but Mezzi will find the trade and one that does lead it back to a 2v3, but across like that, Mezzi, that's going to get you killed. You'll be a little bit more careful.
Tech 9 there in close range, but Mezzi doesn't quite name himself the frag. Ash gets one onto Bertie, but nice trade there from Target Bone.
Who is Target Bone again, did you say?
That is Dream.
Dream, okay.
Dream from Kaz, Dream Roma. Was a pair. Yep. Not anymore though.
Well, we'll call a rip for that at some point. I'm sure there'll be a UK CSGO post.
Are you insinuating something?
Dafsan, 2-0.
2-0 right now. Two rounds of the lead for Dafsan. Is that... No way. I've never seen that flash before. I wish... Anyway, Autorex has changed it. Logsy there and Dart is cleaning up these nice and easy eco frags. Oh, tap Lord there in his name. Dream there with a nice three one-taps with the Tech 9. Making it 3-0 right now. And here comes the first buy. Will they keep on to the famices? Yes, they shall. So... With the double Fama setup and the weak firepower, we could be seeing fast B presence from the CT side. Also, five rifles here on Dog Gaming. So, again, could be seeing a contact play, a fast play, maybe a mid-control take here with overboost. I believe that's what we shall be seeing. Actually, yeah, as I just mentioned before, heavy presence towards B.
Logsy, gonna find the opening. Pick over from Sandbag, but quick to be punished. Damage being dished out by Ash. Dancy's gonna find one in return, though, so... Overall, some very early frags, but I think the big thing about this matchup is they find early frags and then things slow right down to almost a bit of a stop. The only thing that is almost a bit of the same is this vent pressure.
Pressure indeed. Yeah, sorry.
I was like, are you okay?
Yeah. I was blowing my nose when you tried to throw it to me there. Anyway, hopefully Dafsan and Co don't blow this round as already got the man advantage and 1 minute on the clock. So, peeking towards Highway with no flash will be dry peeking this one. And dry peeking, they shall fall. Dream another nice frag onto Ash, making this 2v4. Vent is Pop trying to force a rotation there. Trying to have one of those A players walk into Mezzi's crosshair, but instead, Thomas there giving away his position, breaks the vent and gets the frag. Quiver falls, low HP, gets a second kill as well there. Nice aim from him so far this game. He wants that AK so bad. he dropped his gun. Logsy dropped his gun. Did he? No, he didn't. For a minute, I thought one of the players had jumped up there and dropped his gun for the AK. They did.
You know what? I'm at the point in the evening, Snods, where I believe
I'm
that anything
so
can happen.
Honestly, I'm the same.
Anything is possible. So, anything can happen. And one thing that, well, it's on the cards at least, is Dog Gaming, quick, aggressive Tech 9s. perhaps a couple of headshots, perhaps a round on the board and a bit of an odd man, or perhaps a bit of a far-fetch call, and maybe seeing 5-0, who knows, so far. Two quick picks, Thomas, and good old target bone there with the AWP and rifle to combine. Things well, not looking perhaps too pretty after all.
Thomas as well, getting more and more kills. Actually very well known for how good he is at eco-fragging. But enough of that, because Ash does force that molly. I mean, Thomas has so far been getting kills in all the important rounds as well. So, let's take a look at the scoreboard. Dream 9-1, 30-0 for 2, but obviously team is 5-0 ahead, so not really too much action for him. And the auto sniper coming up for Thomas, he loves that weapon. I wonder if he'll be going towards sandbags. Sandbags, watch boost. When we go connector and just spam that mid-main smoke, we'll see. Oh, it's actually going towards B.
He may be going towards B, but look where the cavalry is heading from the top gaming side.
Yeah, for sure. I'll be seeing heavy A main presence here for the T side. And actually, I believe they're going for a shroud boost here. Well, that player playing code.
Oh, Mezzy just tapping on through, more than happy to punish.
How often does that happen?
That's got to be more than 100, probably higher than that.
More than that. Way more than that. So, Thomas here with his auto sniper, flashing, peeking, trying to get information, see if there's anyone B, and there is. Debase up, rips the head off of Thomas, and Mezzy with a nice, another nice frag there from him. It's all down to Dream and Bertie.
A lot of pressure going to be on their shoulders. After all, it is a 2v5. Well, are they even going to try anything, or are they just going to sit tight and try and take what they've got into the next round? Of course, you have to pay big attention to the clock when you discuss that topic, because 55 seconds, that's a long-ass time to save.
They are playing so slow. Is Dream holding the angle? Oh, the timing! Wait!
That was a tag, though.
Wait,
what was a tag?
He whiffed? No, Dream tagged Quiver. Quiver whiffed. And now they know where the AWP is, and they're going to act on it. They will be going towards the B-bomb site. Bertie here in connector. Not really too much you can do here.
Hit the base's position as well. Just push it up somewhat to make sure that no crazy push is going to take place. And the way I see this right now is they're kind of thinking to themselves, okay, boys, we've got the bomb down. We haven't taken a single loss. How about we do some damage? But talking about damage, Bertie gets to punish Quiver. That's an AWP out of the hands of the T-side.
There's a player in Squeaky, mate. Oh, Yoshi. Catching Bertie off guard. And that will mean Dream might actually be able to save this AWP. I wonder if they know he's here. Yeah, they do. Yoshi finds that second kill from Squeaky with a jumping headshot. That's a tilter.
That right there is a tilter and a curveball. I'm kind of looking at the economy of Loxy right now. He's a bit all over the place, but going to get dropped, of course, as that's fairly stable off the back of them being 5-1. And a bit of a similar affair for Dog Gaming as well. Everyone across the board can afford something nice and comfortable. Singular AWPs, actually a double AWP setup for Dafsan. Now, curious to see where Bone is going to head with this course dance he's now bringing onto the table as well. It looks like it's going to be a solo AWP up towards the A site now. I'm pretty concerned. It's also back of the amount of A pressure that Dog Gaming has been putting down, putting a solo AWP. That's relying on Dancy's hitting those shots.
It is indeed. So, Thomas towards vent. I'm going to catch this player out that is playing to a wall. Oh, he's in A main. He's in A main, he's on boost, he's fine. So once again, a slow default coming from Dog Gaming, trying to find a frag, trying to find a push from the CT side, and then play the numbers game that way with trades and so forth. Still though, 1 minute on the clock, and none of these teams have quite shown their hand just yet. Very default play for both teams, and actually, the CT's opting to give up mid and have more of a rotation towards the A-bomb, so I quite like that play. Giving up mid, have the AWP, watch the highway push. They know they can't go connected, and the B players know they can't be flanked. The biggest problem right now is there's not really too much backup for the B-bomb site in case any of these players do fall.
Yeah, it's all about covering your asses in the grand scheme of things when it comes down to that.
You love it, sure. You love it, don't you?
Just making sure that you are not going to be receiving any surprises.
There you go.
Dog Gaming over towards A main. Step
by
step,
the timing!
Hit themselves closer, but look at that. That's the surprise we were talking about right there.
If you want to insert anything PG-13, it should have been right there. Anyway, Debase up does get a second kill for his team. Well, the first kill for his team is Thomas and Dancy's chime in for frags. Can Dancy get any more? No, he white faces into Quiver's AWP. Dream, though, finds that kill into the AWP up. Mizzy with a nice headshot. He's really been coming to play today. If he can win this 1v2, could be really cementing his team in position to bring the comeback. Bertie will find that frag. 6-1 and the reset for Dafsan.
Longevity being a key factor for Dafsan at this point, really starting to build things up, Snods, and kind of want to ask you, how long is it until we start to really see the signs of dog gaming and whether they actually are going to start to wake up somewhat? Because these rounds have been close, but I mean, it is getting to a point where it is 6-1, and we start to take over to 7-1, to 8-1, and it always gets to that point where you say, okay, can dog gaming really bring this back and make it a healthy half?
I was about to say, I'm really So, for me, Dafsan, they're going to have a stronger showing on the T side. That's what I was, you know, initially expecting. Problem for me right now is the fact that Dog Gaming haven't really got anything going for themselves just yet. It's definitely quite a worrying sign. But Logsy here, just a FAMAS and four players coming his way. It'd be very hard for him to hold this unless he has strong backup from his partners, and he does. The rotation from Highway comes in. Thomas is here to support his teammate. We could be seeing 7-1, and then, you know, following that Ecos and so forth. All to play for in this round. This is probably the most important round of the game.
Well, Rotate's beginning to take hold as Quiver gets himself up in towards Connector there, just to fill things out a tad. Was Mezzy going to take a bit of a drive-by on towards Logsy, but doesn't really get too much done. Not quite going to hit that. Nice try towards Quickie, but hey-ho, why not try?
I was going to say, you need an ult for that.
You can try, but not going to happen nonetheless. Thomas there to hold off the door now. Almost certainly aware of that player in Squeaky, which I think is ever so important. But he's just going to bounce around across. And I'm intrigued. I said Quiver was subject towards Car, but that was a mistake on my part. Quiver's sitting up towards AMA. And one of the reasons I want to highlight his name specifically is I want to see what he can do, because he's in a bit of an acquired spot. Can't exactly peek out on towards the site. He's just almost sitting tight waiting for a push.
Talking about pushes, Loxy does shut that down. Actually finds two. Can he get the third? Yes, he can. The base up does get the kill onto Loxy though, but not after he found three kills. And now, oh my god, Bertie, how have you whiffed that? Dances though, on the ball. Gets two nice orb shots there.
It's a beautiful second shot.
That was very, very nice. Lag. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear, Bertie. That was quite a whiff. That was on stream as well. Thanks to Auto Director.
So, 7-1.
Yeah, shout out to Auto Director. So, 7-1. The quarter buy coming out here from the T side, as they do have enough money to buy the next one. 1v1 me at Rocket League. As they do have the money to buy into the next one. So we will be potentially seeing 8-1 on the cards. And already, it's already been 9 rounds. It's been a fast game.
Yeah, very, very quick. Just a blink of an eye, and things are already looking to, well, pretty much take hold at this point. 7-1 is a score, and that it is getting to that bleaker narrative.
Oh, this is going to be straight out.
Dancy's trying so hard, but unfortunately unable to really make too much of that. Only one pick for him. The rifle now into the hands of Mezzy, but has no Kevlar, which somewhat limits his power.
Oh, it's a nice shot there from the base of the Tech 9. The long range headshot does take down Dream. And we are going to a 3v3, but the players have no armor. And Bertie saying, you know what? F the AWP. F the rifle. I'll pick up the AWP. Can't whiff of that one, surely. So
he's very patient in this approach.
Yeah, doesn't get too aggressive. And, you know, if he dies, the round really does end at that point. It will be a 1v3 on either of these bomb sites. So he doesn't want to throw away his life just yet. Just holding for the push towards Connector. It shall be Thomas to be tested here.
Yeah, I think I just look at that AWP as now being a gatekeeper role for Connector. If Birdie can just make sure Connector is well held, pretty much okay. And you talk about Thomas, he's able to do his job, gets to pick on towards Mezzy, but just off the back of Bertie failing, now look at how much harder Thomas' job is going to be.
He's got these players taken from all angles. Heaven, CT everywhere. Gets a nice kill there, but these players have no armor.
Oh, Thomas!
Yeah, one bullet from the M4. And obviously the T's players can't really shoot back, and Bertie has not had too much of a good 2-for-5, and he's definitely been in position to get kills. Definitely been in position to get killed. AWP hasn't worked. M4 didn't work. It's time for a FAMAS buy. Let's see what Bertie can do here. So, five AKs for the T side. Might be seeing a fast mid play here. And off that, maybe go for a fast B split. But the bomb is in mid main, so might be telegraph for a slow play. Get some aggression towards mid, try and find the first kill. And then work off of that.
Angles being held by Dog Gaming, they're trying to really force the hand of Dafsan at this point, saying, just please, just give us something, something that we can pull towards. A shred of hope almost. That 8-1 scoreline is fading further and further into the distance. There's going to be some early vent control being taken, but one that is going to be met with a pretty big gift coming from Bertie, who's standing there just pretty tripe with a famous Crossfiring up with Thomas with that open. Well, that's a tag. Quite a shot, but one nonetheless. A second on towards Messi. That is beautiful. Now holding the angle, gets another. Looking for even a third, and well, the crossfires of the orb, they kick it into high gear, and well, it's going to be a cannon fodder effect to take that one home.
Well. Dog Gaming, definitely trumped at the moment. What has he changed his name to? Bertie changed his name to Evanescence. That's the, oh my goodness, he does love it, doesn't he? So, Nade there doing substantial damage to Mezzi, only on 25 HP. And already five of these TE players heading towards the A bomb site. They want to try and catch Logs with guard again. It happened one time. Will it happen again, though? Dance is getting tagged up just a little bit. Still trying to spam that play. He does get the headshot killing anymore. Does get a nice one tap there. Spots the players leaving out A main through the smoke. And we'll get more frags this time. The last play is Squeaky. Just the base up. And Dream will get that frag. 10-1.
So, a bit of a throwback. So what was the fourth round or something when I asked you, when does it get too fast, Nods? Because it's 10-1 right now. And
getting... Yeah, this is getting out of hand.
It's getting way
too fast. It's definitely getting out of hand. 10-1. And the buy does come out. Dog, if it happens now, sorry, if it's going to happen, it has to happen now. If they don't get anything early, I just don't see them winning the mid round. You've seen what's. Where was that pick? That was towards B. Okay, so Dream has fallen towards B. That might. Okay, Yoshi as well finds the frag onto Dancy. So already, very weird plays coming from Dafsan. Maybe some overconfidence to say, to put it lightly, but frag towards B, frag towards A. What do they do with these kills? Just wait and allow, you know, Logsy to walk into his crosshair. That's one thing. And if they lose this, then that's just it. That's over. Come on, Bertie, please. Come on, Bertie, please.
Got there in the end. Thomas, still going to be looking to make this one work, by all means. Now that they're kind of almost grouping up as well, I do like this. And oh, what? Bertie, just deciding, you know what? He's just chosen his line of work. I'm going to tag through a smoke. Why not just go for it completely out of nowhere and get himself a pick? The baser looking to turn it back on towards its head, though, as we'll punish him. Your return is sitting towards CT, leaving Thomas back all on his own in a 1v3, but gotta be said, you gotta give it to Birdie for that.
Yeah, taps away at the feet. Does find himself, but kills for himself there, and obviously that wallbang was quite nice. So, Dog Gaming, they do manage to get this round, make it 10-2. Ash there, cementing it. So, 10-2, seven rounds apiece, separating these two teams. Biggest problem for me right now is if Dog Gaming lose this and get reset, we could easily be seeing 12-3 or worse. Potentially even 13-2 if the reset does come through. Well, that rhymed. There you go. Still on the ball. Yeah, sure. So, I keep saying so, my goodness.
It's kind of the buzzword of the day, right?
Yeah. Is all falling apart like Dog's T-side. So.
Touche.
Touche.
Logsy. This AWP over towards Squeaky. Yeah. This scares me, I'm not going to lie. This isn't very conventional. And you're facing into a rifle and Dancy's. And Dancy's hasn't been missing. And he's not going to miss again. Thomas and Dancy's, they claim lives respectively. They are happy days. Dog Gaming already at a two-man disadvantage. And all we're looking left to say is, where on earth are they possibly going to go from this? And, well, why not? That was certainly a display in itself over towards mid.
Oh my god! Yoshi!
Welcome back to the server, Yoshi. He's making it happen. Just another run towards Thomas. Now looking for just one more. Mezzi gonna be there to hold the angle.
Oh my goodness, he's done it! How has he done that? Just imagine his grin right now. Oh my.
I can always picture his smug langering all over.
That is the
best. Kind of like another hype moment, really.
That is the best play we've seen all day. By far. By far. Yoshi there. Somehow, some way, making it 3 board for his team. You're seeing 10-3. And already they spot the early aggression towards mid main. Doesn't want to headshot his teammate, obviously. But here comes the pop off.
Yeah, pretty much just going to be looking to mow them down. And that's a shutdown. And that's so influential in terms of the kind of economic power, should I say now, because we've gone from looking at what would have been a 12-3 to a 10-4 that could be a 10-5. Now, if this is a 10-5, completely turns everything we've said about it being too far gone back on its head, because 10-5, we never expect to be here, but it's just, well, we're out of seconds reach almost for Dog Gaming now.
Problem is that if they do lose this one, and they do lose the following pistol, we could be looking at 14-4. So this round and the second pistol round is so pivotal for Dog Gaming to qualify here. But we are seeing fast A main presence from the T side, and will they be matched? Yes, they shall. Quiver finds the kill onto Loxy. Yosh as well, bursting out of that door, finds the kill. Dream though, trying to equalize the numbers. Let's get one, trying to get a second. And the fact Auto Director's on him right now gives us a slight clue that he shall get that kill.
I gotta love Auto Director really taking advantage of his ability to try and predict the future. Thomas, over the rifle just to try and hold off this cross. The base will face into him, and they have clear knowledge that now he's going to be there, but they keep on facing, they just won't stop, can't stop. But it is going to be quick trades nonetheless that lead us back to the same old moot point, which is Naga Bone. Splitting them both off, this is ridiculous.
He's whiffed.
Played it well, but not quite enough.
He's whiffed. 4 HP though, Mizzy. So far from Dafsan, they've got 10 rounds on the CT side. That's so strong from them. I really didn't expect such a strong. And we'll be seeing Thomas and Dream leading that 16 kills for themselves. This pistol round is so important. The difference between 13-5 and 10-8. Just think about that.
I don't think you even need to think about it. I think it's pretty self-explanatory at this point.
Yeah. Dog Gaming, I don't want to say they need a miracle, but they definitely need one of these players to step up and try and net themselves the second pistol round here. Because otherwise it could get out of hand.
Well, it looks like Squeaky going to be the favored point for Dafsan.
Is he teaching... I think he's teaching him how to smoke mid.
Wait, what?
He's like, yep. Because he shot, he's like, yep, you aim, go here, aim there, yep. That's how you smoke left side mid.
That's Logs beautiful, that is.
On the ball.
That is actually beautiful.
Oh my god, can he get any more? How did he get that second kill? Oh my god, Thomas down there, 1v4, gets one kill. Can pick up the USP here as well. Or the P2000, excuse me. Oh. Has the bomb as well, it hits the fadeaway one tap. And the B-hops to follow it up. Definitely going to go down in style here if he dies. Picks up a flashbang and an HE. He wanted to do an ace if he wants to secure the second pistol round for his team. And we'll slowly rotate towards Squeaky. Is Squeaky door open? Yes, it is. So, this is definitely a game changer. You can go to Squeaky, get onto the A-bombs, like get the bomb down. Oh, it might be a game too
aggressive.
Yeah, he's on the site. I wish we had an observer right now, but he's on the site, planted the bomb. Here it comes.
Popping up a flash, a little CT heading over to his quad.
No way, no way,
and they think
way.
It's B. No. Dog Gaming, this is not really the time to make a mess of things now. They finally seem to clock onto the fact that it is going to be that A's like, they're running hard and fast. They do have a kit on the base, so Snods, it's not how they would just yet. They still have a certain shred of hope they can make this one possible as they begin their push. Thomas is going to be there to push on him, and he will be taken down. So it is going to be the round. But goddamn, that could have been absolutely disastrous.
Yeah, that could have been very messy. So, Dog Gaming, the bomb does go down, so potentially seeing 10-7, and then the bio comes in from Dafsan. Thomas, definitely showing off his aim today.
Yeah, really hitting these shots.
Yeah, just fadeaway, nice and clean headshots. That's what I want to see. So, full eco coming from the T side. They don't want to give away, you know, a force buy here. They don't want to buy they don't want to buy Galils. They don't want to play it risky. They've got a 4-round advantage. Just play nice and safe. Allow Dog Gaming to get to 7, and then play from there.
Going to be a smoke booster rolling out through mid these pistols. More than happy to try and use brute force to their advantage, but the rifle, well, overpowers them nice and easily. Pistols, not so much, but we get there in the end. Mezzy going to be looking to make some money with this UMP, just trying to chase down Bertie. And he will do just that, a quick headshot for him. And Thomas, next in line, is Quiver going to find just another to really add up that money. 10-7, I mean, Snods, this is looking much more competitive now that Dog are on the CT side.
It's only been a pistol run, mate.
Yeah, but I'm believing. They look like they can actually play more well-held together Counter-Strike.
It all comes down to how they want to play this 5-round for the teams I'm talking about. Do they want to play aggressive? So you know what, boys? Aim-wise, skill-wise, we're better than these 5 players. Abuse it. Talk about abusing. They've got 3 players towards B. Lines 1. My game crashed.
Yeah, not gonna lie. You sound like you're lagging a little bit as well. So, yeah. That's happened, leaving it all on towards me, so I'm gonna have to go to town with this one, but I'm sure we can have some fun as Underscore, gonna find one of his own. Making that to a double kill quickly for him as Quiver gonna head up towards Heaven now, spraying on down. Dancy's ever so low, 22 HP. But it's looking like they are going to be able to make this one work. Darcy, he's a lot of pressure on his shoulders. But he's not in a position to even clutch this one out. Quiver, going to keep on spraying on down through. He's right down to the wire here. Ever so close to our body on the other side of that metal sheeting. But it isn't quite going to be the pick. The smoke, on the other hand, is going to be what arrives. But that bomb just on the other side. And with flashes and Molotovs alike in 55 seconds on the clock, Dancy's, he may have time. But that's all he has.
I am back, by the way. That's a good throw. So, Quiver on 13 HP. Ash is well low. Dancy's can do it, though, with this one spray. But unfortunately for him, timing does get the favor. Quiver spots him out. Doesn't get the bomb. And on low HP, will fall. So, yeah. The fact that there's four players on the screen crashed my game.
Nice.
You love my PC. How much FPS you got? I've got 150 FPS.
Honestly, I don't actually know. Like, I turn Netgraph on, but that would involve giving out GoTV.
Oh, movies. You're on the stream. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah, you're right. So yeah, was not good there. Four players on my screen and my game just froze, basically lagged out. So, five players come from the T side. I'm starting to make this so thing coming mean, but who cares? Five players getting sprayed down right now. Let's see how many they can get. Actually, Dream, they have two kills. The bomb should be planted. Dream has the M4 but no armor. Thomas has the pistol and the armor. Actually, Dream picking up a molly there. Could molly off CT and get a better position. But instead, he shall face and dink up that player. And Thomas will fall.
Well, there you have it. Things really starting to string together, at least for now. 10 to 9 is going to be where we find ourselves heading towards. And, well, still waiting for that response from Dafsan, really. Gonna be interesting to see what the AWP can break the table for this T side and whether they go for it, which of course they haven't brought it up on any of their players.
Haven't
done to Bertie, but no, they want to go five flat rifles.
Heavy boost mid, maybe a fast A. I believe it should be the mid boost. Boost of a mid, get control of mid, and then play from there. Let's see what happens. Yep, boost towards mid. They're boosting two players. They want to play the angels right now. They're playing nice and slow. They don't want to give Dog any chances here. They want to just abuse the fact they believe they have better aim and better skill. Ready to play interventions. Well, Mezzi's caught this pair off guard. Flash comes in, sprays him down. Thomas falls.
A team play triumphing. It's going to be the trade found by Logsley, but you have to kind of really give respect towards Quiver and the angle he's playing. A nade is going to be flung on towards the site and a bit of damage to be done, but I'm still all eyes on towards Quiver, really, and doesn't quite spot out Logsley, but.
Ooh.
Second and third cross. Well, perhaps a bit too confident on that, but Quiver going to find it in the end, punishes Bertie. Logsley next in line. Dancy's finally going to find one of his own, flips up towards heaven, finds just another. Maybe in a 1v2. Make that a 1v1.
Oh my goodness, Dancy's now. 3k of him this round, it's going to be the 4k. The base up, rotating in from CT. Does Dancy's expect it? Such a hard round for Dancy's to win here. Such low HP. Once the base of faces, it's going to be... Yeah. Swaps the foot. That's game over. The base wins on 100 HP. We'll be seeing 10-10. But the bomb goes down, so we'll be seeing another buy for the T-side. And AWPs, everything. Everything to play for.
It's the economic stabilization for Dafsan. It's just been so perfect for them in terms of allowing them to keep on fighting, keep on having all these opportunities. You mentioned Thomas as well. 22-12. That's nothing to be complaining about in comparison to pretty much every other player.
Definitely been stepping up here. Bertie, not really having the best game of his life so far, but then again, he doesn't really care too much about... I know he quit after the M&M thing. Came back into the game a little bit, had a few team offers, a few trials here and there for some top teams, actually. But obviously, opting to not take this game quite as serious as a lot of the other players do. So, obviously, if he does come back into it, he was very good when he played, so... Debaser hit on the Shroud boost. Watching a main and actually spots out one player, sprays down two. That's a nice spray transfer there for him. Can he get any more? Yes, he can. Three with the Tech Nine now bouncing around, jiggling around, trying to get that headshot onto Dream. But he won't find it. The bomb is on the site. And that nade. Oh, 14 HP now, Dream. The bomb should be planted. Should be seeing the 2v3. And nades only on Bertie. A flashbang trying to get the frag. They need this kill. Dream spraying, but doesn't quite connect it just yet. Tap away on his head, just waiting for the push. Taps him down. Ash falls.
Oh, Quiver over towards A main. Just got to tap straight on through towards Car, and he's happy to take that one. As Birdie gonna find one of his own in return up towards Highway, and Quiver yet again just pushes on through, and his persistence is gonna allow him to take this one home for the team. The Snell Stock Gaming, they have the lead.
They do indeed. From 10-2, was it? 10.
Yeah. Pretty much.
10-1. 10-1. They were 10-1 up. 10-1 up. They got overzealous. They threw away a 2 versus 4. And look at them now. 10-11. Quite mirroring the fact of what we saw with Whisk and Ziggy and Co versus the Smuya and Shank mix. Unfortunately for them, they did end up, I don't want to say choking, but not winning that one.
I mean, it kind of was though, wasn't it, really? Yeah, I think you have to kind of be honest with yourself. Yeah. It really was. And I think that's the same thing in this scenario as well. I think Dafsan have played exceptionally well in the first half, but...
I don't know if it's just a choke, more of a, lads, we've won this, you know, last come out in team speak.
Overconfidence kind of ties hand in hand.
I'd say lack of experience for the Whisk mix, and then right now, overconfidence here. Dafsan, they're really underestimating the actual team play of Dog Gaming on the CT side. Right now, it's definitely paying dividends for them.
Squeaky certainly going to be playing a factor into this one as well. Waiting to see what Thomas is able to achieve from that spot. And also Boost as well. Mid control. That's going to try to take this every single round practically. And usually they get themselves a reward, but already quickly shut down by Underscore.
No flash there. And Ash shall be traded. Underhand flash there from Yoshi. Peeks out towards mid. Spots one player. And actually, they're jumping on each other's heads. Bertie. Dream. They both fall in mid. And now we're seeing Yoshi there pick up a nice 2K. We are in the 2 versus 3 once again. And again, only nades of one player. A Molotov and a smoke. And what happened last time was they pushed to try and get the frags. It didn't work out in their favor. Let's see what happens this time.
Thomas, the man over towards Quad. Logsy, the man towards Forklift. Peeks on out, looking for that first pick on towards Quiver. Makes it to, well, a bit of a success, but that Molotov is enough to burn him on through. Molotov's being a bit of a weak point for Thomas now as he gets caught in the fire of the flames. Hash to put to the left. That will reward him with a quick frag, but Mezzi, he's hungry for him. He wants this one, and he's going to go aggressive. Jumps on down, taps with a crouch, and is going to go straight tapping for that defuse. And, well, there you have it. Dog Gaming, they're going to keep on pushing, and by the nick of time, they get themselves to 12-10.
Mezzi there, jumping right to give the sound cue. He's going to the right side box, and then swings it back around and sprays down Thomas there, making it 12-10. How many rounds in a row have they lost?
It's been seven rounds back
to back. It was 10-2. Yeah, it was 10-2. They've lost 10 rounds in a row.
Yeah, plus on the second half, or first half as well, sorry, yeah.
Yeah, adding into the, yeah, 10
it's
rounds in a row.
Substantial.
And here comes the Tilt Rush B. Let's see what happens. Dances and Co. pushing through the B main position. Only one player on the B bomb site. Can they kill him? Yes, they can. And this tilt, no, I don't want to say tilt, but the call to rush B could be the deal sealer here.
It's a CT play that is a deal sealer. Quiver finds himself a double kill. Gonna throw down the nade as well. That's surely gonna meet onto the legs of Dances. No. And he's barely 7 HP. They do it all, a 1v2. And you keep saying the phrase tilt, you keep saying you don't want to say it, but in reality, tilt, choke, it's all the same. It's all coming back to the same moot point. They've lost so many rounds in a row. It's so substantial. It's so huge. Something has to change because if they keep letting this happen, Dog Gaming, they're going to snatch this qualification spot from pretty much right under the carpet.
I like the way they play this as well. They've doubled up towards checkers. Bertie, there's no way he expects this. Smoking off CT. Good smoke. And obviously, wide faces there. 7 HP. Not really too much here. Quiver peeks out and sprays him down. We'll be 13-10 right now. Another bomb plant, though. They've lost 7 rounds, but they've planted 6 of them. So they've lost more than 7. They've lost 8 rounds, and they've planted many of them. So,
money the bomb plant certainly has been a real strong point.
Yeah, I mean, they have the buys, they have the money. It's not like they're on eco, it's not like they're being reset here. They're in position to win rounds that is not able to bring it to fruition. And we are seeing Dog Game with a 3-round lead. I don't think they're giving this one up. I do believe we could be seeing a 16-11, a 16-12 at this point. Unless Dafsan turns it around.
We can certainly hope. We saw just some real great stuff from them in that first half. And it's just unfortunate to see the way things are swung from them now. So hopefully, some coffee beans or something can wake them up, slap them in the face when we see a bit more of a refreshed Dafsan. But, well, with the lack of a pause, it's a bit of a hard affair to call upon. Some early damage is going to be inflicted. A flash here and there, and well, one that leads towards Loxy's very premature death. Already a man advantage for the Dog Gaming side.
Yeah, no trade there for the T's. Strictly a one man advantage, and that's that. Loxy trying to go for the hero play towards B. Trying to get control of checkers, trying to bring up a rotation for the CT side to allow his players and his teammates to go A. But instead, he falls, and this makes it very easy now for the CT's. And I've just given this round the caster's curse, which means they're probably going to lose it.
Well, judging off that, things have at least been equalised, but the bomb has gone down. Look towards Bone's position, finding one in towards Connector. We'll want to flick up for the second as well. Very smart flash coming out, but falls rather short. And DeBaser will take full advantage of that. Find the frag and force the hand. And my Quiver as well towards Karts. Going to be this duo of Quiver and DeBaser to push on through, but let's talk about Quad. Quad has been such an influential factor. They molly off every single time, but that molly only does so much.
There we go. Finally, Dafsan and his teammates find a round of the board. And to mention Quad, we see it's always the one versus one. The last player is always Quad. It's like it's the last place that the cities check, right? Peak highway, you peak close car, you peak A main, then you peak forklift. They molly forklift, they flash it over the peak site, and at that point, you're either squeaky or you're Quad. So, finally, though, Dafsan, after losing how many rounds in a row was point? It must have been, what, 11? Yeah, 11 rounds in a row they lost. They finally win this one. And if this does happen, wherever Dog do win this fourth buy, personally, I'm seeing this being 16-11.
Well, you've made your prediction. The curse has well and truly been inflicted, but let's see if it really is going to meet its very neurotic end. It is going to be a bit of a slow-burning push to what looks like the A site. Of course, presence, as always, is going to be placed up towards Boost. Bone looking for a one-tap towards Bowser and will receive. Gifted on towards the head of DeBaser, but what can Yoshi do here? He's been huge in the past. He's going to find one with his pistol, but unfortunately unable to get a second as Bertie finally inflict punishment upon. Curious to see what can be done towards Connector as Bone flies on out, gets himself one, and hey-ho, take that curiosity to a whole new level. Get one, get two, try and get the third, but Underscore is going to at least stop that from happening, letting things just not reel too far off the wagon. But the bomb's down, it's ticking. There's only so much you can do with the CZ. It's pretty much about minimizing his losses and maximizing the damage he can do at this point.
Yeah. So far, strong game here from Dream. Dream is obviously target Bone, but honestly, you know, players like having different names for whatever reason. Dream, though, 27 frags for him. And they've been quite influential frags as well. Not really too many ecos because seems like Dog have been having Dafsan on their ecos, even though they've got the bomb downs, bomb plants down. But strong game so far from Thomas early on, and then Dream in the middle portion and the latter portion of this game. Logsy dies. Logsy just dies. And that's an AK. Whoa. Well, Logsy lad falls. 12-13.
It's a bit of an interesting standpoint, really, because now you kind of do have to look towards economy. You know, really, let's actually rewind a bit here, because in Counter-Strike, you have all of these factors that come towards the prediction of a round when you're kind of analyzing and saying, okay, this is what's going to happen. This is what you usually on a standpoint say is going to happen. But this is just not really following the norm, because what we're seeing is a lot of sporadic pushes, a lot of kind of hoping for the best with the odd rifle here and there, and a lot of pistols finding frags they really shouldn't be able to find. Case in point, Yoshi going aggressive and finding a frag on towards Dancy's that Dancy's had the angle for.
He did indeed, and actually Yoshi there finding a nice CZ kill. But Dream falls, and he's been the star player as well in the second half for his team. Thomas, though, starting to light himself up again after the, such a strong first half. Makes it a 3 versus 3, and at this point, I really do feel like it will be 13-13. No armor on Mezzi and Quiver. No guns as well. Just a USP in hand. Just the AK on Ash. Good boost here, actually. Trying to see if they can catch a T player off guard who's saving. If not, we will be seeing 13-13. Strong economy as well now for the Ts. 7,000 will be eventually 10,000 after this round, and then obviously the rebuys will come in as two players at full, but still. If Dog win the next one and make it 14-13, Dafsan will be able to buy and make it, you know, potentially 14-14. So they do have money leading in case things do go south.
So in reality, what we've really reached is a point where anything can happen. We have two possible victors in this matchup right now. And if we're honest, we don't know which way this is going to swing because we're looking at 14-14s, 13-13s. So it is all to play for. But it comes down to what these 10 players on this server can bring. Who is going to hit their shots? Who is going to blunder? And which team is going to triumph? An AWP into the pocket of Bone. Four rifles. A similar affair for the Dog Gaming side with the AWP back onto the quarter Quiver. Two very talented players with those snipers. And two players that have been on and off throughout this entire match. But yet again, it comes back to that same old story. Are they going to hit it in some of the most important rounds they're going to play as Dancy's finds the aggressive pick on towards Quiver. And one by one, things begin to equalize.
What a heartbreak it would be for Dog Gaming if they do eventually end up losing this. Imagine the adrenaline you've got from winning 13 rounds in a row. You thought the game's over. You thought you've, you know, outsussed them. the game's in your hand, and then suddenly out of nowhere, they win that one round, the 3v2, or the 3v4, and from there, it slipped. And Dream makes it a 5v3, and right now for Dog, it's definitely slipping away, because if they lose this, they are reset once again.
It'd almost be awkward, I think. It has to be said, and you talk about it slipping, that was... Oh, this round has been a bit of a... A round that was full of deaf ears, I think, is the most appropriate way to put it, because Dog Gaming, they haven't done anything at all. Yes, you can argue they've done 60 HP worth of damage. Well, go you for that, but at the end of the day, that doesn't really mean much in the grand scheme of things. What means and what matters something is that Dog Gaming, as you mentioned, they had such a valiant attempt stance. They were winning so many rounds back-to-back in a row, and they weren't necessarily close because, you know, at times some of them were, but for the most part, a lot of them were very one-sided affairs towards the end. Now, well, at least, you know, look at this round, for example. Been pretty much an ace across the board. Mezzi is going to find the first two. Eventually, he's going to be punished, but for the most part, still a perfectly clean round from Dafsan.
So, will they force a play for OT? Smart call here. I think this is a smart call to go for OT. They're going to allow Dafsan to reach 15 rounds unless a miracle happens here with TZs or 5-7s.
I mean, this is the point though, right? I wouldn't be surprised. I honestly wouldn't. I'm looking at players like Yoshi, looking at players like underscore Mezzi, and they've all been finding a lot of picks with these pistols. At times, they've been finding more picks and more impact with these pistols they've been doing with rifles. It is going to be a three-man setup over towards the safe site with a bit of an aggressive push in towards BMA. Mezzi just going to be playing around those boxes and actually trying to perhaps even swap over towards Sunroom to get some information if it is going to present itself.
Yes, indeed. So, again, pistols. No armor. Good molly there. I mean, obviously, there's no one there. They're on the other side to the right. Unfortunate scenes there, but instead, we'll be seeing... I'm not too sure which player that is. I think it's Mezzi. He's been the... Yeah, it is Mezzi. He was the B player earlier. Oh my god, he can go huge.
See, this is the pistols. This is what we were talking about now. As he finds himself one, looking for a second. Gonna get overwhelmed by the rifle and the AWP, though. But look at this quick rotate. Still, things can happen in long-range shots. Thomas. There you have it. Quiver gonna punish Thomas from that range with a P250. And curious to see if Thomas even fired a shot at that point.
Why is he pushing that circumstance? He wants to get that 30 bomb, I can tell. He's sitting there on 28. He really wants to get 30 kills. I mean, you don't need to push there at all. Still, though. These players have no armor, so it's definitely looking like we could be seeing 15, nevertheless, on the side of Dafsan. Loxie there spraying, eventually gets to base up. Dances, Loxie gets a second from there. We are seeing 15, 13, and here it comes, down to the wire. Dog Gaming have the buy, AWP on, Quiver. Mezzi as well, they could go for a double AWP here. Instead they do go for the rifles and utility, good call. What's been working for Dafsan so far? Heavy A play. Seems like they are winning these angels. And things are going their way, especially in the afterplants. We saw they were winning constant afterplants on the A-bomb site. Can they keep it going in their favor? Thomas now boosted, wide facing towards mid. Passive setup from the CT side. One player towards highway, making sure no one can get towards connector or vents just yet. They're not giving away any early frags, and I like this.
One of the most important things about this round right now is every single player on the server needs to realize they're not playing for the win. They're not playing for 16-13. They're playing for a qualification spot. It's so much more on the line than simply saying, yeah, we beat Dog Gaming. So much more. So you have to play pinpoint perfect. You can't afford mistakes. You can't afford to be playing for a KD. All you can be playing for is each and every single round.
I think Messi's done it again behind the boxes. He's done it. Let's see what happens. Can he get multiple frags here? He's behind the wall. Sprays down one. This little bot is going to kill. Sprays down a... And the bomb does not get planted. Oh, it is being planted. Sorry. Mezzi, they're not quite getting that frag. And now Yoshi, though, the reface, does find that kill onto Dances. Quiver holding that B main angle. But right now, there's only a player to the left of him. Here comes the retake.
The retake should easily be doable, but do bear in mind the low HP, especially with shots like that being landed. How does he get second on towards Mezzi? That is ridiculous now, leaving Quiver to try and make something work up towards Heaven, of course, tapping down on towards Loxy, lands himself one, and need to go down as well. Debater gonna push on through even further. There's no angles he can face. Dog Gaming, they get a chance to fight. That is ridiculous, and do they even have time? They do, thankfully.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
I was worried for a second there.
So. 15-14. It's just the money to play for. High stakes here. As the winner of this will go and qualify for UK Tours. You think about the money as well. This is the difference in money. Winning this one round for Dafsan could potentially be hundreds and hundreds of pounds. Just off of one round of Counter-Strike, ended in 2 minutes.
All to play for. One team will be the victor. One, well, maybe potentially put on hold for overtime. Which way are we going to swing? Well, that is the question. We're going to find out in just 1 minute 30 or less. It is going to be a slow formation of Dafsan beginning to build up over towards this A site. They're looking to go back towards their old faithful. They were winning these angels early on at this site. All they have to do is just do it one more time. Step by step. They are inching. Just
here it comes. Here comes the pressure. Quiver now watching towards white box. The flash comes in. It's a bad flash. Quiver capitalizes. Thomas is down. And now Dance is here, peeking towards Forklift, trying to find another fry quickly, but can't get off the angle. Such a strong showing in for Dog and Debaser. So that's it. This has to be it.
So Torshroud find one, gets a second, is going to be responded by Bertie. So a 2v4 back on the table, but this shouldn't be able to happen. We should be seeing a mop-up just take place clean as ever. As Yoshi is going to get himself that pick, looking now for the second. Well, I'm going to find one in return with the AWP, but that aggression should easily be met by Quiver, especially with a flash coming in from Bertie.
Starting around Forklift and falls. Mezzi takes him. We're in OT.
We are going to overtime. And I've got to say, I don't think there's any better way that this match could have gone. Honestly. Just look at how we've got to this point starts. We've seen
the
team
win. MR 10. MR 5, sorry.
We've seen the team win.
A while to go.
10, 11 rounds in a row back-to-back.
Yeah. I mean, we saw one team win 10 in a row. Then we saw our team win 13 in a row. It's been crazy. Absolutely crazy. Momentum swings here and there. No pauses, though, funny enough. But enough of that. Straight out of the cusps of the OT, we're seeing a fast air rush. Quiver, no flashbangs, means easy frags for him.
He's just almost a bit of a chicken shoot at this point. Finds one, makes it to two, looking for even a third at this point. They're still not killing him. Lines it up for the collateral. Gets the tag on towards Bone. 14 HP is what he will walk away with. And they are the last two remaining. A nade right at his feet to end that one down. An assist for him as Yoshi claims just one more. And right out of the gates, death is met. Dog Gaming, that is a perfect start.
Dafsan there trying to catch Dog off guard. Quiver though, they opt towards highway with no flashes, no utility, easy picking. They want to just take the angels, but the angels aren't going to work versus the AWP of Quiver as they do take this one. And now, probably, yeah. So they're not going to do the same mistake as last time. Stupid, raw rushes with no utility. Instead, they're going to play nice and slow, play default here, play for the mid round and see what they can get from that. And again, it will be a 1-2-2 setup. For the CT side, one player playing towards A, and the counter boost coming towards mid. There's no one watching it. He could get back into behind the T play in A main. This could make a massive difference here.
All comes down to timing. Stance is going to find one, but the trade is going to roll back on through. Looking at that bomb, but it's still not quite making the moves just yet. Could head up towards boost or head through A main. A lot of choices, Snods, and a lot of predictions being made on where it's going to go towards. A lot of things changing as well. As Bone going to keep on pushing forward, and bit by bit, more people are falling. Dog Gaming, they might have started off strong. They're getting their comeuppance. Especially, he'll dish out by just one man. It gets himself two kills in that scenario. Yoshi still playing up towards Rafa's, finds one, looking for a quick second. The birdie finally giving him the man to put the nail in the coffin.
16-16. As well, leading into the third round. 1-1 so far in this OT. We'll be seeing the 4-by again. Money, still strong on both sides. So obviously, they did win the round, so... And the rounds did win, it'd be quite convincing as well, I believe. I can't quite see, it doesn't show me the number of how many players stayed alive, but the money is strong so far on both these teams, so... A lot of the times, in these MR5s, you see, what, 7-8 rounds or 4 buys in the last two, usually pistols versus you know, rifles and whatnot, so...
You can always talk about pacing themselves when it comes down to making sure they manage things appropriately, especially the aggression coming out from Bone. Really starting to hit these shots. If he gets away with a second there, it would be absolutely ridiculous. The second time over, they take the B site. Where is the contester from the CT side? Dog Gaming, wake up. Don't let them do that to you. Don't let them just push through a smoke with a flash. Simply not quite good enough. They need to be able to hold that.
Stewie UK going through the smoke then finds that kill. And now the rotation is going to be so hard. Thomas set under vent. Should be just silencing this rotation from this player.
Headshot for him.
Falls. Yep.
This is heartbreaking.
Molly,
to watch this.
Again. Well, Logsy falls, but at the end of the day, the round's still going in favor of Dafsan. And still, we've got many, many rounds to come. It's first to 21. Yes.
Yeah,
thanks, lads. Yeah, first 21. So already 17 for Dafsan and Co.
I'm just looking at things and how this has unfolded and looking at individual players. Just take a look at Bone right now. Just take a look at that scoreboard.
At who did you just say?
At Bone.
You sure you said Bone?
Yeah, target Bone.
Okay. I had something different. So
I'm sure you
would. I know what you mean. 38 frag. 38 to 23. Such a good showing from him. Good thing you brought that up. But a big thing to bring up as well is the fact that Dafsan, it was their CT side where they got the majority of their rounds. And right now they're already on T2 on their OT. So definitely under pressure here for Dog Gaming. They have to rethink and re-strategize their CT side if they want to pull this one through in overtime. Bone faces. Spots the player. Doesn't quite get the kill though.
Interesting decision coming in from Thomas. Just going to keep on tapping. Yoshi, stop on that boosted angle. Misses the shot though. A flick that almost certainly he wanted to find. He's going to throw down a flash in reflex. But even then, Bone just going to sit tight and eventually lose his life off the back of the baser. You know, on that elevated angle up towards what would be railings?
Heaven. Or railings, yes. So, one man lead. For Dog Gaming into this fourth round of OT. Oh, Dance has done very, very fast peek onto Yoshi. That changes everything. We might be seeing a rotation here. Someone leaving B, and actually they are. Oh my goodness, if they go towards B here, that'd be such a good read. They need to understand the situation. They need to understand they've got the Kalei. A rotation will come from mid, and a player will leave B and go and take mid. So if they play their cards right here, have the boost over towards... Well, have the boost on boost. Have that player cut off the rotations towards Vent and try and get the B bomb site that way. We could be seeing a very good round here for Dafsan.
Rotate's beginning to form though, so I was expecting some sort of effort to be made up towards Heaven. And well, it is going to be a quick trade nonetheless. Thomas and Dancius though will combine, and Dancius is going to be the man to edge at least somewhat ahead. Thomas is going to try and at least contest things, but he's being pushed quickly from Headshot, but he's fully aware. Let's his teammate die. Finally will respond, but perhaps a little too late.
What'd you say? What'd you say to that? Oh my goodness. If this goes into another OT, right? Thankfully, I haven't got work tomorrow. Okay? Just think about that for a second. You know Shane used to complain on Twitter how he's got work. If this game goes any longer. My goodness. Anyways though, definitely very intense, very close. 17-17 on the board in the final round of the first half of the first OT. Debate of the first kill. We haven't even seen much aggression from the CT side, and definitely paying off. Quiver holding an aggressive angle as well towards their main. Gets flashed off of it and has to retreat and fall back. Debate is trying to get second. Does get the dink though onto Dancy's. Has the AWP though, so it's not the end of the world for him.
Quiver, there to find just another pick, and that nade's surely going to dunk right onto the feet of Dancy's. He's almost used to that ending at this point. Time and time again, he has fallen. Similar affair. Waiting to see. If that bomber's going to get dropped though, right at the cusp of Quiver, is just pushing even further aggressive now. So hungry for frags at this point, but why not be confident? That's really what's worked out for him. That's
that
a shot.
That looked like a team kill then. That definitely looked like a team kill then. Logsy, second one. I didn't know it was an AWP up. Bertie as well finds a kill from...
Oh my God! Bertie, you absolute monster! Mezzy now on a 1v2. The tides completely have changed. Dog Gaming looking to at least take this half by storm with a one man... Well, one... One round lead, should we say. But Mezzy, well, he needs to make something happen here. He needs to make something happen fast, as that bomber's going to keep on taking a Molotov to go on down. Gets himself on the flip side of red. But Logsy's actually ahead of the curve with this, because he's just going to sit tight in that corner. And, well, the minute Berzy knows now that push is coming in, the angles are going to be held. And
so
there's
well
nothing
played.
That can be done.
So well played there. Not giving Mezzy a chance to get back into that 1v2. Three rounds of the CT side. For the T side, sorry, for Dafsan. It's about as many as they got in regular time. So very good showing from them. It's looking like Bertie's woken up as well. That's such a nice flick there. But right now, the man of the hour is Dream. Target, Bone, 38 frags, 38 to 25. Thomas as well, not at 34. First round of the second half of OT. 5 AKs. Can we telegraphing a fast mid plate or maybe a contact A? And I believe it should be the latter.
Flash here and there in towards A main. Not quite going to be slowing down Quiver though. He's just going to keep on walking, but walking right into the cross there of Loxy, who gets not only one, but two. Now looking for a third, just goes for a bit of a rapid sway and potentially a frag over towards Squeaky, but it's going to be a Molotov instead that will force Yoshi away. Which is, you know, in fairness, all in good time, happy days for them. Really nothing for them to be complaining about on the CT side, as they have a 2-man advantage. They take a minimal damage aside from Loxy. They get just another now on towards Yoshi, as Loxy's just absolutely destroying them with a 3k in this round, and that pretty much leaves Dog Gaming licking their wounds, wondering what on earth did we do wrong.
I only see those shots from Loxy when he's got USP in his... My goodness, maybe the transition is happening right in front of our eyes. So, AWP here from Dancy's to hold the law, hold this B-bomb site, and allow Dafsan to get to 19. And only be 2 rounds away from locking themselves into the UK Gaming Tours.
So much to play for, so much value in this money.
Debaser lands it. This could force the rotation from B, and it does! Dancy's, though, smart enough to not over-rotate. He stays B. That's it. They know there's one player. He's dead. Dances into the last player. Has to be towards B. Faces. Takes him down. Ash falls. 19-17. 2 rounds ahead now for Dafsan. This round. If Dafsan win this, the money... Oh, they're still going to be strong on the dog side. If they win this, they will be guaranteed second overtime if things do go south for them. But right now, we are looking like Dafsan to take this.
Some incredible plays. Some incredible players. You talk about Birdie, right, for example. Birdie has had a bit of a mare when it comes down to his overall statistics in the game, but you know, I think you have to kind of stray away from overall stats sometimes and look at individual importance to each scenario. There have been some huge impact frags from him at certain times, especially in clutches. You can't take that away from him, no matter how bad global statistics may be at times. At least he's waking up when it counts. Squibber running a bit of a similar affair with a quick pick with the ADOP on towards Bone. Taking by far the man of the hour out of action is a pretty solid start.
For sure.
They have a lot more to do.
Yep, Dream does fall there. We are seeing the man advantage already for Dog Gaming. Quiver's trying to get more as well. Slow peeking, doesn't want to peek into the op. Just yet, gets the kill. Thomas falls on the rotation towards the A-bomb site. But do they expect two players to still be here? Oh, the whiff though. That's a nice shot again. Luxy though. Oh my goodness, that could have been it. That could have been it. Imagine if you got that kill, it could have been the 2v2. But Bertie needs to get here quick before the bomb goes down! Oh. That should be it. Quiver should get the 4th himself this round. Flash comes in.
Oh, there's a little bit of doubt in your voice there now, Snouts.
Yeah, I know.
I like you're starting to believe.
Molly towards, I don't even know. No. He didn't tap the bomb.
He's going to go stick it now by far. He's definitely just going to go sit in that smoke, tap on E, and he's going to be hoping that he can find this Diffuser Tech 9 spamming on away, but he's not quite finding it. Is this actually going to happen? This is ridiculous. Dafsan, they get themselves to 20, and it's all off the back of Bertie, a player that everyone is doubting. Everyone is looking at his performance and saying, you know what? You played absolutely terribly early on in this matchup. Well, take a look at that.
He didn't even tap the bomb. He threw a smoke with a bomb, didn't tap it, just wide-faced his car, versus Lop, who cares? And then sticks it. And he saw what happened there, as soon as the bomb was defused, just the life taken out of Quiver there, just stood still thinking, how on earth have we lost that? Thomas there, don't know what you're doing, refacing 3 times. But still, Yoshi does take him down. Debasing gets tagged up as well by Dancy's. And Thomas there, quite salty about that one. But nevertheless, it's going to be Quiver facing towards mid. Did get a few kills here in the previous round. And the 4k for him, but the 4k, so the 3k just wasn't enough. Bertie there in the 1v3 somehow, some way manages to win it.
Absolute insanity. But one thing is for certain, let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. Dog Gaming, they are still fighting. And they're keeping it up pretty damn well, already getting themselves that 1-man advantage. But Dafsan already right ever so close as well. A bit of a similar affair and getting themselves that ever so mentioned qualifying spot. The base of the round, just 21 HP, but that's enough for them to work with. Looks like they're going to be heading towards that B site.
First kill there. Ash finds the frag onto Dante's Yoshi as well. Kills Logsy. Unless another miracle happens here for Dafsan.
Oh, Bertie, how on earth are you getting away with that? He's going to get punished by Underscore, but jeez. Huge frag there. Should almost certainly be over. Bear in mind, 4 HP. It is going to be over. Yoshi is going to find the frag, but Bertie should not be able to pick those up.
For a second. For a second. I thought that was doable.
Wow.
So, 2018, two rounds separating these two teams. Dog Gaming, they can't win it straight up. They need to go to double overtime. And Dafsan just needs one more round to secure this. A little bit of damage going back and forth, but we'll only be 9 damage done to Ash there. We are seeing a slow round. There's so much pressure on these teams. They don't want to be the reason for the team to lose the round. Potentially be out of the tournament. Thomas here, playing for information, spots nothing, re-smokes it, flashes, and then falls back. It's a bad smoke though. It's a very bad smoke. Gets headshot, luckily for him, through the wall, and Dancy's has found that kill onto Yoshi towards Squeaky. And we are seeing right now a one-man lead for Dafsan.
Birdie holding tight, gets himself that headshot on towards the base. Equivocus is going to find one in return. But is it going to be enough? It is a 4v3. You can already see Dafsan looking to decide, okay, how do we want to approach this? Rotates on the table. Thomas comes out over towards highway right now, punishes that mid-presence that Quiver is providing. This could all but be done. Dog Gaming really need to make something work here. It needs to be beautiful. And pitch perfect at that as well, as Dancy's going to take down Quiver. The peak coming in from Logsy. And this is it. This is our qualifying team. Getting right down to the wire. Underscore going to find himself a double kill. Looking to get that bomb down. Got to toggle plant it here and there. Doesn't quite want to stick it straight off the bat. But look at how close they are to CT wall. The Molotov going down onto his bomb as well. A reflex flash being thrown on him. That's it. Birdie is going to end it. Dafsan, they got to take this one 21-18. GG.